Hi, I'm Dr. Elliot Adam from ElliotOracle.com. I'm also the author of Fearless Tarot, How to Give a Positive Reading in Any Situation, which is out now from Llewellyn Books. And if you like my positive approach to tarot, or you just want to take tarot reading to a deeper level than superficial keywords, this book is going to be awesome for you. It's time for this week's Oracle Reveal. So earlier today on Instagram, I placed up a photo of three different animals, and I asked you to use your intuition and ask yourself which animal's calling to you, because that animal has a message for you. And if you're just joining us now, the animals were the lion, the swan, and the moth. So just ask yourself, which one's getting stuck in your head? Because that is the animal for you. For a lion, it says, be generous of spirit. And lion's the regal animal. I mean, when you think about it, the king of the forest or the king of the beasts. And so this could be a time where you're really stepping into some sort of regal action. Lion is associated with capturing attention and also commanding attention. So this could be a time when you really want to use your voice. You really want to stand up. You want to be more present in your life at this time. The first card for a lion is where it's best for them to place their focus this next week. And we get the Knight of Swords. And you can see the Knight of Swords here. He's rushing ahead on his horse and he's, you know, thrashing it and he's yelling, go faster, go faster. And for me, the knight is a representation for the inner kind of voice in your head that's telling you to do more, be more, stretch more, achieve more. And the horse is a symbol for your physical body. And the horse on the card is just exhausted. Sometimes this card says, lessen your intensity a little bit. It's not a race. Calm down. Be kinder to yourself on the process toward your goal. Don't be at war with your own body or your own mind, and don't stretch yourself out too much with stress. So sometimes when I see Knight of Swords, I just advise people, let your shoulders drop. Breathe. Relax. Second card is going to be advice from your inner wisdom this next week. And there it is, the Hermit. He's so much the opposite of what the Knight of Swords represents. The Hermit's an old man with a cane going over snow. So you can just imagine how fast he's moving in comparison to the Knight of Swords. And the Hermit could be indicating that it's time to get calm. It's time to slow down. It's time to get centered. And also the Hermit is all about reconnecting with your spirit. And he's illuminating his pathway through the dark. And it's illuminated by this lantern with that star inside of it. And what this is indicating is that your inner knowing, your inner spirit is going to reveal just enough of your path so that you know what the next steps are to take. Although you may not know how the whole journey goes or how you eventually reach your goal, you don't need to freak out or be frantic like the Knight of Swords. You need to really delve into that inner knowing of your inner Hermit and just plod along methodically and let the path be revealed to you step by step. And then finally, the mythic archetype that will be helping you if you pick the lion spirit is the four winds. And this could be a time where there is a new breeze blowing into your life. Things are becoming more clear. The four winds are associated with the element of air, which is all about being cerebral, logical. And in fact, all three of these cards are kind of mental in their approach. This really takes you to the seat of your mind. But you're being told to take that more calm, centered, in tune with your highest, best self Hermit path, rather than the frantic, fearful movement that's going to make you tense right now. So just calm down, look at things in a really cerebral way, and also just take your time at this time. The second animal is the swan spirit, and it says, time for a deep dive. And when we see swan, it's also an archetype for transformation, like from ugly duckling to swan. And this archetype can tell us that, you know, none of us is a finished product yet, that we're all working on improving ourselves, or even our projects don't need to be finished and perfect right now, but that we need to just trust the process and go with the flow. Transformation's happening. First card for you if you pick Swan is where it's best to place your focus this next week. And we got the Judgment card, which is always a card of rebirth and renewal. You can see that the angels blowing the dead, blowing the trumpet, and the dead are coming out of the grave. They're living again. And what this is indicating is that right now your spirit is stirring you to action again. It might even be a time where the old dead parts of your heart or yourself or your goals are starting to stir back to life again. You may start to feel like you're resurrecting, or like the phoenix, you're coming out of the ashes again. So this is a tremendous time to start anew or to invite rebirth into your life and your projects. Take those things off the shelf and breathe new life into them. The advice from your inner wisdom for the people who pick Swan is the Death card. And right in alignment with that Swan archetype of transformation, the Death card is also that symbol for letting the old reality, the old identity die, allowing something new to be reborn. Always with that Death card is that sun that's rising over the horizon, or it could be setting, but whether it's rising or setting makes no difference, because as the sun is setting here, it rises there. And this is saying that in your own life right now, this is a huge time of transformation. In fact, in the major arcana, I think these are two of the most powerful cards for personal transformation. You not only have that death archetype, but you also have the rebirth archetype. So it's sort of saying, you know, one doesn't go without the other. You can't live in a vacuum right now and feel like, oh no, I'm losing something, or something's ending and this is terrible. Because the Judgment card is actually promising that your ending is a rebirth and a renewal in disguise. And finally, the mythic archetype that will be helping you if you pick the Swan is Cerberus. He's the guardian dog of the underworld. And when we see the Death card right next to Cerberus, something major is transforming within you, but it's requiring you to go deeper. And the underworld in myths is a symbol for our unconscious, for what's deepest within us. And what this could say is that it's time to get back in touch with maybe the darker places within yourself, the places that are shrouded in shadow. And it's time to spend some time there. It's time to look at what's trying to be grappled with or dealt with or even grieved, because that is going to lead to your rebirth and your renewal. There's no rushing through this process. You're going to have to contend with a major transformation that's starting from within you first. And then finally, we got the Moth spirit, and this one says surrender now. And so this could just be a time where you're really surrendering to your own transformation, your own change. And also the moth is like the butterfly of the night. So there is some transformation that's happening in the darker places, not just for the moth, but it looks like for the lion as well. The first card for Moth is where it's best for them to place their focus this next week. And we got the Eight of Pentacles, which means meaningful work, really investing your time in something that is building a better future for yourself. Also with the Eight of Pentacles, you see the figure who's striking a chisel with his hammer repeatedly. And what this is saying is that the best pathway towards success for you is consistency. It's not just having the goal, working hard on it one day, and then saying, okay, well, I'll get to it when I get to it. The Eight of Pentacles is kind of a card of building some structure around this, or making a schedule, and just repeatedly plugging away at this thing until it gets completed. Also, the Eight of Pentacles rewards your hard work. So whatever you're investing your energy in at this time, although it may feel a little bit like a grind or a little repetitive, the Eight of Pentacles promises a reward down the pike. The advice from your inner wisdom, if you pick the Moth card, is the Nine of Cups. And this is a card of wish fulfillment. It's also a card of preparing yourself for the best success. You see the figure here who's seated before the table, and it's set up with nine golden cups, all like trophies behind him. And what this is saying is that there is time that's being needed in spending it on setting the table up for your future success. It is one thing to just hope and wish for something to go well. It's another thing to actually roll up your sleeves, get out into the world, get into the fray, and really do the work of setting that table of your success up. So I feel like there is some intentional action that's needed along with wishing. You're really deluding yourself if you're thinking, well, all I have to do is wish for it and it'll just come to me, hopefully. The Eight of Pentacles and the Nine of Cups say that all these rewards that you're hoping for can happen, but you got to put in the work for it. And then finally, the mythic archetype that is going to help you this next week if you pick Moth is Theseus, the hero who defeats the Minotaur. And the Minotaur is the animal, the bull-headed monster that's in the labyrinth. But here we see Theseus, he's sort of grabbing the bull by the horns. And I just get the sense that for the Moth people, that this next week, don't procrastinate, don't make an excuse, grab the bull by the horns and just get this thing going. If you do, you're going to feel your self-esteem is rising and it is going to feel like your goal is within reach. So that is this week's Oracle. I do hope you enjoyed it. And if you did, you can always check me out at ElliotOracle.com. Otherwise, I hope you all have a safe, healthy, and happy week. And I will see you again next time.